Hello, Meg here from Pmtv UK. I hope you are all well. I'm back with another new guitar, straight off the back of NAMM and January. There's been so many new product releases, and of course there has been some new Taylors. Not just any new Taylors this year, it is the 50th anniversary of Taylor, a crazy milestone. So of course they have done a line of 50th anniversary acoustics to celebrate. They are all absolutely stunning, quite unique, and so far I've had the pleasure of playing three from the series. I'm really excited about it, and I think you are going to absolutely love them all too. This one in my hands is the AD14ce. It's from the American Dream range, which is still a relatively new series for Taylor. If you aren't familiar with this series, the American Dream range is still a relatively new series for Taylor. It takes its name from the original workshop where Taylor started back in 1973. These were bought out in honor of that, and also as a way to use some more interesting tone woods. And this particular guitar, and most of them in the series, use walnut as a back and sides tone wood. Now, this isn't the first time Taylor have used walnut as a back and sides woods. I believe they've been using it for a couple of decades now across different lines in the series, but it's definitely not as common as your mahoganies and your rosewoods. The American Dream have a completely unique tonal sound. They've got unique build qualities and some really cool features that set them apart from some of the standard models you see from Taylor. I think from the offset it's easy to see that with the finish on this guitar. You don't get a lot of sunburst finishes from Taylor. So it's something I loved about the original American Dream 17 that I played a couple of years ago, was the sprayed sunburst finish on the top. This guitar, of course, has that, as well as some unique features that make it a 50th anniversary model. There will only be a very, very limited number of these 50th guitars made, so if you want to get your hands on one, you have to get in there pretty quick. I'll run through some of those particularly ornate details, but first, of course, just going back to that tonewood pairing. If you have played a Taylor, you've played a mahogany or a rosewood Taylor, you'll be familiar with that classic Taylor sound. Big, bold volume, lots of projection. The V-class bracing helps a lot with this. Well, personally, to my ears and from all of the walnut back and sides guitars I have played, it tends to have a far more unique voicing than the other ones that I've played. It sits somewhere in between the two voices, so not quite as bassy as rosewood, but not as mellow as mahogany. It's got a lot of high end and it's paired with a spruce top. It's great for clarity, really good for finger picking. Hopefully you'd be able to hear that in some of my demos. It's a really comfortable guitar to play. But as I said, lots of different styles work well with this tonal wood pairing, and it's a bit more unique for an acoustic. It's one of those woods too, a bit like koa, that is going to settle in over time and you will probably get more projection come through and a bit more bass. There's lots of headroom with a walnut back and sides guitar. A really nice visual feature on this guitar, which also comes on the 314 from the 50th series, is the firestripe faux tortoiseshell pickguard. It looks really cool. I haven't seen these really on any other Taylor models, so it's something that you'll probably only find in these limited run models. It goes so well with the sunburst finish. It's got a real retro look to it. I think Taylor themselves call this a neo-vintage style of guitar, so it's got lots of nods to a vintage acoustic, but with some modern features like that pickguard, make this stand out quite a lot from the other guitars on the shelf. As well as that, playability wise, the guitar has got chamfered edges around the whole body, so it's nice and comfortable, especially when I'm sat down like this. The edges aren't overly sharp, and that pairs nicely with a Taylor neck, which, if you've ever played a Taylor, you will know by now is super playable, really comfortable. This one has a satin finish mahogany neck with a eucalyptus fretboard. I know eucalyptus is a reasonably sustainable wood to use for a fretboard, hence why this is becoming a more popular choice by Taylor for a fretboard wood. Running up the fretboards, you have some Italian acrylic dot inlays as well, quite a classic for this sort of guitar design, so nothing overly unique there. But when you come down to the bridge pins, you would usually see an ebony bridge pin on a Taylor of this sort of caliber. The 50th anniversary models have a gold acrylic dot inlay on the ebony bridge pins. This pairs so nicely with the gold tuning heads up on the headstock. Again, something that you don't really tend to see apart from on limited run models. So it does set these apart from your standard American Dreams and your classic Taylors that you see on the shelf. Being a 50th anniversary model, inside of the sound hole, it's of course got that 50th anniversary gold sticker, so you'll be able to spot this on the shelves. I definitely recommend giving this a play. Walnut is a hard tone wood to describe without hearing it yourself for your own ears, but it's a really lovely guitar to play. And this will cater for lots of different styles and genres. Not just that as well, if you are looking to gig with it, it of course comes with the Taylor ES2 pickup system. These are great sounding pickups. They're very versatile. You've got bass and treble on there, as well as a phase control switch inside. So you have quite a lot of control depending on which venue you're playing in as an acoustic guitarist. It's got a cutaway, of course, so you've got easy access to the upper part of the neck and the standard scale length of 25.5 inches. It's a Grand Auditorium style guitar, so these will always be the same scale length from Taylor, but they all have such different unique qualities. It's always worth comparing the few models that are in a different series just to see which tone wood suits you the most. Obviously, that is the best thing to do and the best way for myself and you watching to know what this guitar is going to sound like for your sort of genre. So I'll play some sound demonstrations. That's the best part of the video, of course, from my side, and hopefully I can get across just how balanced this Walnut sounds from this acoustic. Let us know in the comments what you think about this model, and if you've already had a chance to try any of the 50th models, let us know what you think. I'm really excited for these to land in stores. I think they're going to be super popular, and of course, being a limited run, you're only going to have that small amount of time to try these before they are gone. If you are gigging with this guitar, it does come with a deluxe padded gig bag as well, so you've not only got something to take it to and from gigs, but you've got somewhere to store this lovely guitar at home when you're not playing it. Keep it safe from the elements and make sure it's always playing the same. So that was a run through of the Taylor American Dream 14ce, the latest addition to the American Dream series and one of the few guitars in the 50th anniversary range, celebrating 50 years of Taylor guitars, which is absolutely incredible. I hope you enjoyed this video. Of course, do let us know what you thought of the guitar in the comments section. And if you want to check out this guitar, we'll pop the links below so you can head over to the website or pop into your local store and have a chat with one of the acoustic experts in there. They will happily set you up on the guitar and give you a hand. Thank you for watching. Make sure you hit that like button and subscribe to the channel so you don't miss any more videos from Dagan or myself. You can come find us on socials as well. I'm losing my voice. You can come find us on socials as well at Play Music Today. We are on all the social platforms. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you soon.